नमस्ते, माय नेम इज मालविका एंड आई एम एट ओपन शेल फार्म. इट्स अ प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ स्वयं वेयर वी वर्किंग ऑन इकोलॉजिकल रीजनरेशन ऑफ द लैंडस्केप. दिस इज आवर फिफ्थ ईयर. वी टॉकिंग अबाउट जोन वन, आवर किचन गार्डन. इट्स लोकेटेड राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ द हाउस एंड द लैंड इज स्लोपिंग टू द साउथ एंड द वेस्ट. सो यू सी, वी लोकेटेड द हाउस इन द लोवेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द लैंड. नाउ दैट इज फेसिंग द वेस्ट. Now, this was a problem in the sense that we could not direct our grey water effectively. However, we solved that problem, but we also made this problem into a solution. Now, the house being on the west side is protecting this entire zone 1 kitchen garden from the harsh sun and the wind that's coming in from the west. Having said that, we are also getting a lot of sun from the south and the wind from the south. So we have put in this whole trellis to be able to shade out this zone 1 kitchen garden and at the same time plant a lot of trees along our south border. So you see, these are little strategies. We cannot change the landform. These are little strategies that we are trying to use to build up the soil, to protect the zone 1 kitchen garden and still be able to get a productive harvest. So you see, like I said, the zone 1 is on my left and this is our south. Now we are exposed to the harsh sun and wind, like I said earlier. So what we plan to do is we plan to plant in a row of trees here, of nitrogen fixers, trees that will grow fast, trees that will shade out a portion of these and then also act as a windbreak and a sun protection. So once we have done this, we have an additional protection of the trellis. And what we did, this is about location of the zone one, you know, how you can strategize based on the orientation of the land, based on the slope, based on your sun angles, based on the wind directions, and based on a lot of these little energies and flows on the site. Now, when we started off, we had a very, very rocky terrain. We did not have soil at all. So what we did is we got some soil from the lake bed, okay, which because we needed some clay. So we got some soil, the silt from the lake bed. And we also got a lot of these banana waste matter that was lying around, you know, around our sites. We dried it and we incorporated that into the soil. Now that was one thing that we added. And then in addition to that, what we did, like you see here, is we broadcasted green manure. Now this will be all chopped down and incorporated back into the soil. What we have here is we have sun hemp, we have dhaincha, we have horse gram. We have some lablab, we have some velvet bean. All of these are going to be chopped and incorporated by our bullocks into the landscape. Now this is just 50 by 50, 2500 square feet intensive kitchen garden, and our plan for us under the trellis is to have vegetable beds like this, which again are going to be incorporated with a lot of biomass. You see, this was a vegetable bed that was made by the participants who came in for introduction course last season. So we're going to make these vegetable beds and have our vegetables growing here. So these are one of the ways that you can improve your zone one by incorporating green manure, by making compost, by strategizing the location. It takes a little time and energy, but I think it's worth it, you know. So we are now in the fifth year and we're focusing on intensive vegetable production for people who are living here. Yeah, so you see, land is sloping towards the west and we have these trellises that are laid out, and we are following the contour for the vegetable beds. Now that is crucial for water management and to also reduce your work and then movement of things and materials, you know, around the landscape. So we have this raised bed that was made from the previous batch. We cleared up the soil, loosened the soil because there's so much of compactness. And if you see, this is how our soil is, you know. I mean, we've taken out so many rocks, but, you know, it's like rocky and stony and dry. So we dug up the beds. It's like a double dig bed. We dug up the beds. We mixed in a little bit of a clay. We mixed in a lot of biomass, diverse biomass from the site, you know, green and brown. And then we broadcasted, you know, a lot of vegetable seeds. You see amaranth. You see fenugreek, you see okra, we have marigold, we have sword beans which are going to climb up the trellis, we have wing beans, you know, we have all of these diversity, we have these purple bush beans, we have all of this diversity building up on the vegetable beds while they're getting protected from the west sun. There's so much more you can do, you know, irrespective of your site being in a very challenging environment, which is a great classic example for us. We're exposed to the sun, we literally don't have any soil. So we're building from ground up.